think what happened around like 9 to 8 years ago was there was a big shift in the way that application, web applications were built in the back end. With the introduction of Node.js, the trend towards NoSQL, you know, so there is suddenly much more lightweight ways of doing this. Cloud became the de facto deployment one for large web applications, and with it, in the last 5 years, there was a lot of trend towards, you know, DevOps mechanisms where we try to deploy web applications in containers. And when we build microservice applications, so the aspect, as Alison mentioned, of distributed, Alison mentioned that distributed computing basically came back into the realm. And lately, you know, this paradigm has shifted even further with things like function to service. In the API space, when we look 10 years back, 10 years ago, actually, also still wrote a paper about, you know, big web services, I think, versus small ones. You know, there was still this discussion between SOAP services and REST services going on. So SOAP was still, you know, a topic in everybody's mind. But I think, starting 10 years ago, you know, REST really took over as a de facto way of building APIs, right? And then recently, you have some more developments, you know, GraphQL. I talked about it in my presentation here. Becomes a new way of doing it. You have more formal instances on top of REST APIs, like open API specifications, which in industry, I can definitely tell you is like the de facto way of describing APIs. So it's really something, some technology that by now is adopted widely. And you have other optimizations like using gRPC or Thrift, you know, so binary protocols to improve the performance of. And on the front end side, and I think this is the most interesting one, if you look 10 years ago, right, there was basically no large web applications written in JavaScript, right? There were like jQuery and Ajax already existed, but if people were serious about large web applications on the front end side, they used something like GWT, so they basically programmed in Java, right, or they used Clojure compiled in JavaScript, but nobody in their right mind would write a large web application solely in JavaScript. And then in the following years, right, what happened is there were more technologies guiding structure, so MVC frameworks, right, the rise of the MVC frameworks in the front end with backbone and so on. But still, you know, Mark Zuckerberg, I think the quote said in 2012 that, you know, the largest mistake Facebook ever made was betting on web technologies rather than going native, right? And then in the past 5 years, we have seen, you know, the dominance of frameworks like React and Angular really taking over, so there's now a lot more structure in building these applications, and currently, actually, Facebook is reconsidering their positioning. They might move back to something that they call progressive web, so they might shift back to the web. So to make sense of all this, the way that I actually see it is, there's a common line between all of these three trends, which is that from 10 years ago, everything was very verbose, right? You have these large-scale backend frameworks, you have SOAP, you know, and okay, in the JavaScript world, you have nothing, basically. But in the first 5 years of this 10-year period, you had a large trend towards simplicity in building these type of things, right? Getting rid of the schema and databases, you know, having dynamically typed languages also in the backend. And at the same time, the amount of structure and tooling that was provided decreased. And I think mid this period that we're looking at, right, there was a trend. I think the complexity basically suddenly, went up with regards to tooling, and the simplicity went down. And if you look for the reason, I think in the backend, you know, you basically, the early adopters of web technologies, they grew up, so they basically had to build large applications. In the REST world, and this was the growth space, the exponential growth of APIs, so everybody just did what they liked. And in the front-end space, I mean, you basically had to invent the wheel from nothing. And then from the shifting point on, I think what happened was this, the maturity of the web companies basically led them to build large applications. And the main problem that they faced were engineering scalability issues, right? Using all these dynamic ways of doing things just didn't scale from an engineering point of view. If you have 100 engineers working on a web application, a dynamic language is probably not a good choice. And at the same time, of course, you want to do optimizations for better performance. So this is my reasoning for why this happened. So let's predict the future based on this. I think maybe it's not very hard to see my point, but if you go once more, I actually think that we're going to hit a breaking point again, and that history is going to repeat itself to some degree, in the sense that I think the complexity of building web applications may reach a height where we have a shift again and new technologies are introduced that try to simplify things once more, right? When I lately look at modern NPM packages and I try to build them, you know, I have multiple transpiled steps. You know, I mean, ultimately, JavaScript used to be such a simple language, right? It just ran, and now you basically have to compile it, and you have to load hundreds of dependencies, and it's already at a point where maybe it's comparable to the Java world 10 years ago. But I'm an optimist, and so I think that while this history may repeat, I think actually, I hope we learn from our past, and the next generation of tools will already have some of the lessons learned in mind with regards to be able to build large and scalable web applications. So this is my main prediction, and apart from that, I'm not going to go into it. I think there's a lot of technologies, and we heard about many of them at this conference, which is great, that will influence the way that we build our applications in the future. Thank you.
Rob.